every time I'm like doing something, I'll know when someone's looking at me. I'll look up and there'll be like people, or like, yeah, like I know, like you feel, I feel like eyes on me. So when I look up and I catch them, then they go, oh, you know, but I'm like, it's cool, it's okay, I'll wave, you know. I think everybody should come see me to get a haircut. I mean, there's the curiosity, like, who's this guy? Is he gonna be cool? Is he gonna clown around too much? Is he gonna be serious? You know, what is this person all about? And it's okay, I'm not for everybody. And once you realize that not everybody's gonna like you, life becomes more blissful and peaceful. I've been a barber since I was 13 years old. My grandfather's a barber, and he taught me the ways when I was a young kid. I made the decision to actually do the permanent clown tattoos gradually. The first clown tattoo I got was, it was my nose. Got my nose tattooed. And I was like, it's a little red, you know? I don't want to wear a fake nose. Let's put a real nose. So we tattooed the nose there. And then the second one was the confetti. I had little confetti dots. And then I got the smile tattoo. And that was interesting. And then I got my eyebrows. But just something wasn't right. It just didn't look right to me. So my favorite color is blue, baby blue, because my eyes are blue. And I decided to go blue. And I am the only blue clown in the world. So I'm making history, baby. Family was definitely like, what are you doing? Like, oh my gosh. But you know, now they support me so much and they understand my message and they like my lifestyle, what I'm living right now, you know? And it's definitely a lifestyle. If I can bring smiles to other people and just make them realize that, you know, not everything should be so serious, bring out the inner childhood, and it's okay to be witty and giddy and just express yourself, you know, that's my message.